How to create a workout plan to lose belly fat. Hi, I'm Irene. Welcome back to the 30-day series where I help you lose your belly fat. Last episode, I taught you how to create a meal plan to lose fat. If you didn't see that one, go back, watch that episode. In fact, binge the rest of them and then come back and join. If you're ready, let's just get into it. Now you're eating at a deficit. You already know the best cardio that you should be doing to lose fat. You already know the meal plan. You know what you need to be doing. You know that you're tracking your meals. You're eating at a deficit. You're eating whole foods. All the stuff that we talked about before. But now you're like, what kind of workouts? How many times a week? How long? How often? We're gonna do a little myth and fact. You have to be training cardio for hours in the day. You have to basically just eat salads all day. You need to live in the gym all day. No life, live in the gym. Better be counting all your calories all day. How many calories was that carrot? How many calories was that piece of bread? Count those calories and freak out about them. Know what I said, freak out about them. Not track them, just freak out about every single calorie. You have to eat whole nutritious foods. Eating junk food all the time is a no. Be 80% consistent with your meal plan so that your workout gives you the best results. Be active every day. Have a consistent routine that's mixed with cardio, weight training, yoga, Pilates, boxing, strength training, spin class, just stuff like that. Step number one, plan. So decide ahead of time what days you're going to do what. So what I do as a personal trainer, when I don't have clients, I decide, hey, which days do I have lots of time? Those are my gym days because they're the longest. Then I go to my body weight days and then I go to classes. So you're going to decide how much time you have on which days and when you're going to do what before the week starts. Number two, create a split. So you're going to take those days. So let's say Monday and Wednesday are your busiest days. Those are the days that I don't go to the gym. So if Monday and Wednesday is my crazy day, then I'm doing a home workout that day. I'm doing body workouts, and that could be anywhere. It doesn't have to be at home, but it's not at the gym. And let's say Tuesday and Thursday, you have more time. Those would be your gym days. With that, you're going to choose how many workouts of what type of workouts you're going to do and how much you're going to do it. So make a category of what exactly you're doing. If you're doing high intensity interval training, you're doing body weight days, you're doing strength days, you're in the gym, maybe you're training legs, maybe you're training upper body, maybe you're going to Pilates, you're going to yoga class, you're going to spin, you're going to decide which days you're going to do what and how many of each category you will be doing. And then that leaves the weekend. Monday, Wednesday, you have one thing. Tuesday and Thursday, you have something else. You can plug your group classes in. And then on the weekend, you can just plug in whatever you haven't done. Which leads me to number three, weekend workouts. You want to plan your weekend workouts because this is the time that you're feeling you're the most busy. So most people have work all week long, and then when it comes to the weekend, they're just like, woo, like time to party, or like blah, I'm not doing anything. So if you're a woo, if you're a blah, then basically this is for you. You're going to want to decide ahead of time what you're doing on the weekend. So what I personally do and what I have my personal training clients do is we schedule a day. Which day that is, it's up to you. And that's the day that you're going to still do one of your major workouts. And you know what you've been slacking on. So you either pick that for one of the days, which Friday or Saturday is the best one. And then the rest of the weekend, you're just living active. What does that mean? Living active, active rest day. You've probably heard it before, but you go out and you just do something not sedentary. So you're out, you're walking, you're hiking, you're doing things with friends. You know, you're not sitting and laying and lounging. So it's really good to rest and it's really good to have downtime, but it's really good to also just get that active time in. And even if it's not actually doing a full workout in the gym or doing a workout at home or doing a workout in a specific designated class, you still can go out and do something. I always just tell my Team Irene Fitness babes, just stay active, just do something. So even if you don't have that much time and you can't commit to a full workout on the weekend, Do something for 10 or 20 minutes, and that's better than nothing. So whether that's an ab routine, whether it's a class, or just running outside on the beach, do something. Just let me know in the comments below, and I will make another video showing you how to make a full workout plan and maybe even like a little guide to go along with it. Bye!